Hey, Wolf. The usual?
Yeah, hit me.
Still looking for your little sis?
Yeah, but no luck so far. At least I know she's alive, though.
It's gonna be okay, bro. You'll find her. Got a light? What's with the box?
I don't even know where to start.
Hey, I got nothing better to do. Cheers.
Cheers. So, as always with me, the story starts with a nightmare. Something to do with her disappearance. Hubris, you're still the most annoying alarm clock in Raven history.
Mr. Wolf?
I woke up from my familiar nightmare to a recurring theme. A headache and a new case.
Evening. I hope I'm at the right place. You are Adam Wolfe, detective of the supernatural? The name is Des Morrigan. I'm afraid I don't have much time. My daughter Susanna is sick and beyond the help of any natural cures. Her disease is progressing. My little girl, this is her.
Looks like a nice kid. What do you mean, natural cures?
I mean, nothing. No medicine, no treatment worked. They only ease the pain, temporarily. The doctors have no idea how to cure her. But this just might. Inside is an elixir said to be able to cure all diseases and maladies. However, I can't open it. Not by force, at least. I tried to puzzle it out, but I didn't get very far.
Where'd you get this thing? And what makes you think there's an elixir in there?
That's not important, Mr. Wolf. Please, help me. And help her. I have to go. It's time for her medication. I'll get in touch later.
And with that, he left. Funny how even with all the drama of the supernatural, it's the simple conversations that still leave me perplexed. That was one intricate and ominous-looking box. Felt dizzy just looking at it. Thing almost took my head off. I had to go see Dez. He better have some answers ready. Hey, Marv. I just sent you a set of fingerprints on this guy. I need his info and his address.
I'm on it. What happened?
He had me open a puzzle box, which supposedly has a cure for his daughter. Damn thing exploded and almost killed me. My whole place is trashed. I better take care of some things here. Text me the info when you've got it, okay?
Sure thing.
Marv should run those prints pretty quickly. Might as well clean up the office while I wait. I saw the window to Dez's place from the street. I wanted to snoop around his apartment a bit, so there was no sense in barging through the door. wasn't lying. The little girl really was sick. But what kind of illness has its only cure inside an apartment trashing magical box?
Daddy, is that you? Help me.
What the hell are you doing here?
I didn't trust you. I was wrong.
Damn right you were. You scared the hell out of my daughter. I hope she can go back to sleep.
That box you gave me almost killed me. It's about time you told me where you got it from.
I know that it's powerful, and that I don't have the skill to open it, which is why I hired you. I'm an archaeologist, and I found there was mention of it in old Sumerian writings. Ended up finding it at that crazy antique seller's that lives by the pier. He's some kind of hobo mystic. Sold me the box for $20.
Crazy hobo mystic? Not my usual choice of salesman, but sure, I'll buy it. Where can I find him?
He's squatting at an abandoned ship near Pier 41 up north. He's not the friendliest type, though. Please hurry, Adam. Susie doesn't have much time.
I didn't get much out of him, but at least I had something to go on. Crazy hobo mystics. You gotta love this job. It was time to visit the docks.
Thank you. Get yourselves out of here. There's nothing left to steal, you friggin' thieves.
Hey, listen, friend. I'm not asking for trouble. I'm just looking for some information on this box over here.
That strange old box, huh? Well, I sold it. But I did keep something it came with in my stash. Now, a while ago, some shipyard drifters stole it. I came after them with my gun, so they ended up running empty-handed. They must have hidden my stash close by. You get that back for me? And then we can talk business.
Thank you.
I found him lying on the ground. Someone was fast. He must have fired that shot in self-defense. Little good it did him.
No, I'm not a vessel.
He let out his last breath right there in front of me, denying he was a vessel. Whatever that meant.